We have the same God. We have the same Father. And the Father delivers one child, He's also going to deliver His other child.
Yes, He will.
So uncover your test this morning. And let me know what you're going through. Your test is the source of strength that I need. As someone said, to keep on keeping. The test that I'm talking about cannot be taken online. Nor do you need pencil and paper for this test. This is one of those keep on living tests. You see, Mama knew what she was talking about. When Mama said, child, you're going to go through things in your life.
Yes.
But you say, Mama, things all right. Not, you just talking. You No, Mama said, keep on living.
Keep on living.
And this is one of those keep on living tests that we go through at times in our life. But you have to study, as I told the young man, to show thyself approved. That when the test comes, you know where to find the answer. And the answer always comes from the Lord. Did you pass the test in 2014? God administered the test to the nation of Israel during their wilderness journey. But the test could have been completed in 40 days. But it took them 40 years to pass the test. How long would it take you to pass your test? 40 days or 40 years? I ask myself the question, how can you fail a test when the answer is leading you through the wilderness by a pillar of cloud by night, by day, and a pillar of fire by night? You see, the answers to the test was leading them all the time. What am I saying, church? The answer to your test is in God.
Yes.
The same one that has redeemed you is the same one that is leading you right now. You might be in the wilderness, but look up. Look up, because God is leading you where He needs you to be. You see, you can only fail the test when you take your eyes off God and place them upon your circumstances. Hallelujah. Peter had a test, according to our church new lesson. The test was to have faith and walk on the water to get to Jesus. Hallelujah. All right. And he stepped out. He had enough faith to step out of the boat. But when his circumstance changed, he took his eyes off Jesus, placed them on his circumstance. Keep your eyes on Jesus, and everything will be all right. The very waves that cover us, make us afraid and discouraged, Jesus walks on. Hallelujah. The waves that the disciples were afraid of, Jesus came walking on those waves. Whatever wave is in your life this morning, don't worry, Jesus is walking towards you. He's coming to take care of you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Whatever test you're taking this morning, remember the answer to your test is God.
Yes, it is.
Moses was about to take Israel into the promised land. And sometime your biggest test comes when you're about to be blessed. Because Satan wants you to turn around. He don't want you to go into your promised land. He don't want you to obtain what God has for you. He tries to discourage you. Keep your eyes on the Lord. Before he took him into the promised land, God wanted him to remind his people that he had kept them 40 years.
My Lord.
We need to be reminded this morning that all that we've been through, the Lord still counts. Regardless of how difficult it seemed this year, the Lord still counts.
Yes, He did. Now, Lord, thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But He says this to them. He said, I kept them in the wilderness for 40 years to test their faith. Hallelujah. To see what was in their hearts. To see if they would obey my command. See, God knows that it's easy to obey Him when there is peace in your life. But when things begin to fall apart all around you, will you have faith and trust Him then?
Lord Jesus.
It's easy to pass the test when you have all the answers already. But if you don't know what you're going through, will you still trust in God? Will you pass your test this morning?
Yes, Lord.
Will God find you? I find out, I should say, what's really in our hearts. Because the test is to search us not from the outside, but from the inside. When He find out that we only serve Him because we love being called pastor and preacher. When He find out that we serve Him only because we enjoy being called stewards and trustees. When He found out that we only serve Him because we enjoy being in the choir and on the usher board. When He find out that we serve Him only because what we can get out of Him. But did you pass your test? At this point of the sermon, I want you to clear your mind this morning. Clear your spiritual depths. Hallelujah. Clear your heart just for a moment. Clear your desk this morning. Clear your spiritual desk.
My Lord.
And write down to yourself what God has done for you this year. Write down what you've been through, but also write down how God brought you out of that situation.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, God.
Count your many blessings. Count one by one. Hallelujah. Sometimes you forget all that God has done for, but God is an awesome God. He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Some of us wrote down that I'm going through the test of lost loved ones. Hallelujah. What a test. Some of you wrote down, I've gone through the test and I'm not sure how I'm going to pay my bills.
Hallelujah.
Some of you wrote down, I'm not sure how I'm going to feed my family.
Yeah.
I've gone through all of those tests this year.
Yeah.
But whatever test you've had this morning, whatever you've written down in your paper, I believe if I was to ask you one more question. I believe if I was to ask you, what did you learn from the test? I believe you would tell me through it all. I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God through it all. In spite of what I've gone through, I've learned to lean on Him. Lord says, draw near to me, and I will draw near unto you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You see, a test will either push you or draw you closer to God, or push you away. So I must ask the question, where are you leaning this morning? Are you leaning on the everlasting arms, or are you leaning towards the exit door? How are you leaning this morning? May have gone through the test of lost loved ones. But did God comfort you when you needed Him the most?
Yes.
I can testify to it. God is a comforter when you need.